Today is 21st October 2018. Okay. This is a 9-month old.
Crossbreed, huh? Female, not spayed. Now, the interesting thing about this is not the spay, because this is quite common operation, but you can turn the head back. I just want to record that this dog emits a strong smell like a skunk. Huh? When the skunk encounters some danger, they squirt out the smell. Now, the smell actually comes from here, the inner sac, the two inner sac here. In fact, I think she must have been doing it a long time because there's no more swelling here. Eh? Does she do recently?
No, because we don't bring her down much because she's too scared. Huh? So, never.
Wait, let me
check. So at home, she doesn't do this.
No, outside.
Outside, only outside. The last one was a couple of
every
days.
Every day?
No. Because we don't bring her down often.
Mm, but last 2 days?
Never.
So normally we check the inner sac here, the 4 o'clock, 8 o'clock. No? And in this case, it's not full. That means she has been doing it quite often.
Quite often.
But you can see the oil down there, you see? You see?
We can see.
You see? She still got some reserves of the oil. This oil on the right inner sac, but not too much. Because she must have been doing it every week.
Every week.
So there's a strong smell, but your house is smelly. Huh?
No smell at all.
No, because the owner is sanitized.
No, she doesn't do this at home, right?
Yeah, she doesn't.
At home, she's most comfortable.
Okay, I asked you, any friends come in and say, your house has a doggy smell?
Don't have.
Any friends? You all will know, you'll stay there, you will
correct.
Did anybody complain to you that your house? Huh? Must be some new person. Yeah,
I think.
Somebody complain. Yeah.
Well, we got two, plus the retriever as well.
Doggy smell.
Normal doggy smell, for sure.
Anyway, so this is a very rare case, I would say, of dog squirting the inner sac oil onto the ground to one of the strangers like vets or anybody. But in the house, normally they don't do it. Let's say if somebody comes in, a new dog or a friend or which she doesn't know, maybe she has squirted it. And the problem is that the house starts to smell of some strong oily smell, the scent. But the owner does not know because the nose is sanitized. They can't smell anything. And they may think that it's just the doggy smell, but actually the house shouldn't have any doggy smell also. If the dog is bathed and groomed. But this one is definitely distinctive, foul smelling inner sac oil. But just now I checked, the inner sacs are already empty. So this dog actually does empty the inner sac oil whenever necessary. I think she must have met some strangers about last week or so. She must empty the oil.
The moment we bring her down, she hears any people, any sound, she becomes terrified.
So actually this dog doesn't need an inner sac surgical removal because she really emptied the sac. Because other dogs, the problem is they can't empty. They can't empty the inner sac. So they always have this backside tail chasing. This one doesn't chase the tail, right?
Doesn't.
Backside,
Her tail, she hides her tail.
Chasing the tail, go around in circles, around the backside of the floor.
Oh, she doesn't.
Those are the cases where the oil is stuck inside the inner sac. So this one is the reverse. It's empty very frequently due to this condition. So the owner is best to bring her out and get her used to traffic noise. This dog is from the home rescue.
From a factory directly.
So it has to be abused as a puppy.
Yes, it was changed up.
And changed up, and she doesn't really trust strangers. So every day, how often you bring out? Twice up?
Probably once a week.
Huh?
Boo every day. But because she comes to a point that we bring it out, she starts to bite her jaw. Then it looks very painful. Because she's too terrified. Initially at home, she was so scared, but after a couple of weeks in boot, at home she's so comfortable.
So the thing is, this is where the owner is actually making a mistake. Because by doing that, then the dog gets worse and worse, you see. So the best is bring her out even for a few minutes to the outside the house, the corridor, right?
Corridor.
Just bring it out, and then probably as many times as possible. This is to let the dog hear the sounds and see the strangers. So if they do it every day, like maybe 3 times a day or more, then the dog gets to know strangers and hear the traffic noise, the city noises. Then this thing won't happen, the squirting in the sepoy. I think that would be better than surgery, because this dog actually is slowly getting easy. It comes here, it's okay, you know, right?
The first time I'm supposed to get out,
there are some dogs even get into fits when they come to the vet clinic. I have some cases. But that's because they see the vet clinic from quite far away, you know, and they went into fits. So that one is very hard to train, but this one is young, so the chances are quite good to make her more socialized. Okay, so.